Right, looking for a startless time. Put it slow. That is so slow. Think maybe Steve's looking to use the horsepower he's got. And now we're in Saloon. You can't just go down there and clean the other driver out.
Well,
you can't. As much as you'd want to.
Right, so down we go. Need a sloop. Having a big go.
If not. Now getting out of it all. Giving it a good go. One go.
Oh, they put a white.
Don't forget too, rest of us, I think Hayden said earlier, all the rest of our meetings here this season at Waikareka Park, 6 o'clock starts, a few goodies still to come up too, as we count down, try and make up for some of the rain outs that have been going on.
Of course, the modified curb cut.
In control of the spoke too soon. Stephen Corrie sticking side by side. Up the inside he goes for the 27 car. White flag, one to go on the one.
Corrie holds on to it at the moment.
A lot of drive out of turn two, side by side. It's going to be a drag race to the finish. Corrie's going to get there. Oh, yes, he will.
Give the thumbs up, say thanks for racing nice and clean, and that they can trust each other. Fantastic, that's putting on a show. That's one of the great things about the Saloons and the Super Saloons is Hayden, isn't it, the way these guys, the respect they have, and been racing a long time, they saw each other, got the trust and respect. We don't see so many the big used to racing side by side.
So Cody Singer goes to the inside of this one, on the outside of course, the 27 of Stephen Corrie.
The advantage, what you want to think about is if you're on the outside set paces, knowing where your power is in your engine and so what speed you want to do this at. It's up to you as they get a green. Right, oh look at the difference, 27 away. He's got the drive, he's got the setup, good on the brakes, the 27 sitting well,
yeah,
right on the
them.
Back,
yeah.
Going for the drag. Can he go around the outside?
Down, big late breakdown into three. Corrie's going to hold on to this one, I think. Yeah, he will.
Oh, I think he's going to know. Slide out wide, but oh.
Is that a new front on the 91 car as well?
It looks like it, eh?
I think he had a few dramas.
Front of the car.
Oh, I think there's a few issues with regulations.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's been going on for years, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
What was interesting too, that just the way that car was bouncing around, so maybe it's suspension not quite set, because you don't really want the car. I don't want to move it around, but you also want to move it on the middle of the track.
Mainland in the 5 car, Corrie in the 27.
Down through 3 and 4 they come. It's going to be a fairly close one, this one, Corey and Mainland.
Obviously someone that's thinking, can we have a go? He's got to see himself up here, see if he can slingshot off the turn, but that car, the little Corvette, Corey, he's got it sorted. Another one.
And Corey moves off ahead of the South 46A.
Cool looking race car.
Oh, beautifully prepared race car.
No brakes or something there, and the full noise into the wall, but there's actually a lot of damage to that car, and right before a wall of it.
The lights are out, they're going to creep down the back straight.
Set himself forward into turn one. There'll be no quarter given here.
He knows where to stick that car, doesn't he, Nigel Ross? As they come out of turn number 4. And away we go, even off the start.
Trying to get traction.
Sitting quite high in the rear end of the 46 car.
Coming off, not getting the side bite. Looks the left front coming up. Corey's stone. I can get in here, because that car's all over the show, but